Ava. Not to have a harmful thought to Buddha. Like a Devadatta, you know. It doesn't mean that we, you know, make the blood, you know, coming from Buddha's body.
Non.
Peut-être je pourrais poser la question des personnes qui suivent des faux maîtres, c'est actuellement assez courant, ce qu'on appelle les sectes. Que faire dans ce cas-là, en particulier au moment où on s'aperçoit que le maître qu'on a suivi n'était pas correct? Si par ailleurs on doit absolument faire confiance.
Qu'est-ce qu'on doit faire?
Je répète peut-être que c'est...
Voilà, voilà.
Si on doit faire parfaitement confiance au maître que l'on a choisi, et que par ailleurs il existe actuellement dans le monde des faux maîtres, voire même des véritables escrocs, quelle attitude avoir dans ce cas-là par rapport à ça?
So nowadays there is a lot of sex and there is a lot of
wrong master.
And so if you have adopted before one of those masters, one of those wrong masters, how to deal with the fact that you gave your full confidence in that wrong master? So how to do when you feel or when you know,
the
when you happen to know that this master is a wrong master? But we are not obliged to do as those disciples who are fallen after the wrong spiritual master. But those disciples who have a strong faith in the wrong master, so it is up to them if they wanted to really pay full debate, full respect.
Thomas. Kono gewe shenye ten dwe che, kono ge gewe shenye ten dwe che, kolo chwe sung yue na, kolo gewe shenye ten dwe ore. Kolo chwe sung me na, chwe tani sung me, kolo dine be karo sung re ta. Lang loba nama dire ten dwe na, kolo gewe shenye ten dwe kaba yue ma re.
According to the definition of a spiritual master, so from your side, if you have chosen that as your master, and if that master have give you a teaching, chö, you know, if that master has given you a chö, the teaching, then he is your master. But if that person do not give you teaching, then he doesn't become your master. But if you have received the teaching, and if you follow, if you take as your master, then you have to follow and continue as your own master. Then not. But someone who gives you the wrong instructions, someone who gives you the wrong instruction, then that is not considered as a correct teacher. So therefore these are some difference, you know, of between correct master and wrong master. Correct master, someone who gives teaching or chö, you know, dharma.
Mm.
ta dungye dungye di dile tharbe thalam kare yore sa
na
dungye dungye le tharbe thalam thabe le tharje kare yore sa
dungye ju dungye le
na te nazu na ba ta di jero
ona ba
ha dile thaba tharje kare yore sa
tu ji ba ro dungye dungye le kuye dungye le thae thau de nyau lo dungye dungye le thae ro
if you try to apply those methods which eradicates some suffering of samsara so then you are also liberated from the suffering of suffering if you train in the practice of three higher training of morality concentration and wisdom then not only you are liberating from the suffering of samsara which includes suffering of suffering also So if you do not think of eliminating your own suffering first, even in the dream it is difficult to think of eliminating suffering of others. It is very clearly mentioned in the text. Someone who never thinks of eliminating one's own suffering, even in the dream, even at the dream level, for that person, it is out of question to speak eliminating the suffering of other sentient
beings.
So in order to generate the great compassion, we need to go through first eliminating one's own suffering, then suffering of other. When we say the suffering of other, it's not just one or two or three beings, but all sentient beings.
ကာရေရာဝေကိုယ်ရှင်ကောင်းသောတေသောနာမှာသံဃာဘုရားတိုင်းကြီးဆုရှိ။ဒါရေချစ်စေခြင်းပဲသနံခြင်းဒေါ်လာပဲချစ်ဆောင်ခြင်းလိုပါ။ဆောင်ခြင်းချစ်တော်ဆုံးခြင်းသောနာမှာသံဃာဘုရားတိုင်းကြီးဆုရှိ။ဒါရေချစ်စေခြင်းပဲသနံခြင်းဒေါ်လာပဲချစ်ဆောင်ခြင်းလိုပါ။ Hallo,
The great Indian master Chandrakirti, he said that while you have all these favorable conditions to practice the path, while you have all these freedoms and liberty, so we should try to make great use of it, means to do all the necessary practices as much as one can, because if you are fallen to the level realms, like once you are fallen to the deep cliff, then we couldn't do anything. When you are fallen under the control of others, other conditions, then we can not to do any of the Dharma practice. So at this particular moment, at this very special moment, we are freed from the most important obstacles of practicing Dharma, and we have most important conditions to practice the Dharma. Therefore, to take this opportunity as like a unique and most the precious opportunity, and therefore one must do a Dharma practice. So why we need to practice the path, why it is necessary for us to practice the path, because all of us like very much ourselves. We like very much, and we have very strong the love to oneself. So if you really like yourself, if you really love to yourself, then the best way to help yourself, best way to get love towards yourself, is to do a path which helps a better human, better future form of rebirth, not letting you to fall to the lower realms. If we do not follow our holy path, or if we do not practice the Dharma, then once you are fallen to the deep cliff of the lower realm, then it becomes too late, and one always accumulates the negative karmas in the lower realms, and there's no way to accumulate positive karma in the lower realms, and one will remain in the lower form of rebirth from life to life to life by doing all kinds of negative karmas, and one may not even hear the word or the virtuous karma. So once when we born in the lower realm, then one accumulates only the negativities, and one never think of accumulating positive karma. This becomes clear if you think of, for example, lower form of rebirth like animals. You see, they know perfectly how to accumulate negative karma, and they never know the how to create positive karma. If you tell to any, for example, animals, they never know to practice Dharma. They never, even if you teach to make prostration and how to repeat mantra and so forth, they never know. They will not know, but they know perfectly doing all kinds of negativities. The entire life is accumulating negative karma. So if you try to think a little bit by taking the life of animal, then it becomes clear that, you know, animals all the time continually creating negative karmas and not having opportunity to learn and to make a positive karma, so thereby they're falling down and down and down, again and again, reborn in labyrinths, and never get time to liberate out of that stage. So to prevent this form of rebirth, right now you have all the conditions, you have a freedom to choose, and once you have make a mistake in this life, then that mistakes become extremely the great the mistake. Therefore, right now you have the power and freedom to avoid, if you want, this kind of lower form of rebirth. So therefore, we should be very much careful to consider this moment as extremely important, not to make mistake in this point, which means to try to avoid this kind of level form of rebirth, because you have all the conditions and you have the power to do this. As I already tell you, that if we really love ourselves, and if we have a tenderness to ourselves, then to avoid this form of lower rebirth, because if you let yourself to reborn in the lower form of rebirth, then you are making extremely harm. You are harming very strongly to yourself.
Alors vous nuisez énormément à vous-même. Oh,
So while you have all these beautiful conditions to practice the path, we should at first try to gain the best, the greatest of the meaning of this life, which means to attain the highest state of enlightenment in this this present life. If not, then we should try to make the great meaning of the medium level, which means to attain the liberation from the cyclic suffering of cyclic existence. And if not minimum, at least we should try to avoid the lower form of rebirth. If you are not able to take the minimum the essence of this life, which is to avoid the lower form of rebirth, then you are not able to take any essence out of this precious human rebirth. It is same as if you have not obtained the precious human rebirth. So to take the great, medium, and small essence out of this precious human rebirth, we should know how to make one's life meaningful. And the best way of knowing how to make one's life meaningful is to strain one's mind in the practice of the enlightening gradual path to the enlightenment, and to train one's mind in this lumbering path. First, we need to generate a correct attitude. Among all kinds of motivation or attitude, the best one is to practice out of bodhicitta, which means that for the benefit of all the mother sentient being, I must attain the highest state of enlightenment, and that being as a mere reason, the only reason, I will practice and listen and train in lumbering path. So now the subject of the teaching, which is the Lamrim, having the following the qualities. It is part of a fortunate being, leading to the complete state of enlightenment, belonging to the great the vehicle, tradition inaugurated by the Nagarjuna and Asanga, hard instructions of the great master Adisha and the Lama Tsongkhapa, the profound teaching, and essence or integration of the 84,000 types of the teaching, a complete path how to attain enlightenment. So this teaching has four main outlines. So to start the teaching, there are four principal outlines. First one is telling the biography of the qualities of the author, in order to say that teaching has a sound reference.
and then explaining the qualities of the teaching in order to make generate faith and devotion in the mind of the disciple to the instruction, and then how to teach and how to listen in such a teaching having the two qualities, and fourth one, how to guide the disciple depending on the actual instructions of Lam Rim. So the fourth of the four outlines, first three have already explained, and now regarding the fourth one, it has two outlines: how to follow a spiritual master, which is the root of the path, and having followed a spiritual master, how to train one's mind. So the first one has already explained. Regarding the second, it has two outlines. So the second outline, having followed a spiritual master, how to train one's mind, it has two divisions: exhorting to take the essence out of the precious human rebirth, and then explaining how to take the essence out of the precious human rebirth. And then the first one has three outlines: recognizing the precious human rebirth. Three outlines: recognizing the precious human rebirth, contemplating its great significations, and then to contemplate how it is difficult. So this the second outline, how to take the essence out of the precious human rebirth, it has three: how to practice the common path with initial scope being, how to practice the common path with the medium scope being, and how to practice the initial scope being. So regarding the first one, there are how to train with the common part of initial scope being has two outlines. First one is generating a mind to attain the happiness in the future rebirths, and explaining on the methods how one attains happiness in the future rebirth.
Mm. Then the Lacho Gunjeta, Lorin Sundin Sundin Demikola, then in a Zalaman is under Nibashi Mahache, Hang Chunujo, Lorin Sundin and Swatu. Did he just talk to Shin Dun, Toshin Madun, and Tamatan Rangju Zalamati? Rangju Lama de Kunji Mingani, Talarin may not join you. May not join you.
So then the first outline, generating a wish to attain happiness in the future rebirth, it has two outlines, to remember the death, is to remember death by thinking that this life will not remain as eternal, and then contemplating the sufferings of the two form of rebirth, lower and superior. So regarding the first outline, we need to meditate on impermanent suffering of laborum and taking refuge, and then to visualize the one's root master on the top of your crown level, and then doing the visualization as explained yesterday.
Then that the messenger tells you, then quite genuinely using it. Shoot up it, then do not have to know one day, do not have to know go one day. Then Chow met up a massage. Chow met up a massage. Near do doing it, and then it turns to Lushuda Machevat. Lushuda Machevat. Wondering a do doing it, Jid and the consul on a new tavern, just Maswan. Only daily it says Macheva, it says Deba Machevi land do some chair. It says Deba Machevi land do some chair.
So then, while visualizing the one's master, in the form of Shakyamuni on the top of your crown level, then we need to contemplate for a while, thinking that if I and all sentient beings are in the cycle existence with full of suffering, is because of not meditating on death and impermanent. And it's because of not generating a fear to the suffering of laborum. It's because of not taking the refuge in three jewels. And it's because of not respecting the law of cause and effect. So therefore, make a single point of request to the Lama of the crown level that my and including all sentient beings, please grant me the blessing to be able to remember and to meditate on death and impermanent, and may and including all sentient, I myself and including all sentient being, generate a wish to attain liberation from the suffering of the cycle existence, and may I and all sentient being generate a strong faith and devotion in the law of cause and effect, and to take refuge in three jewels.
What then?
So then to think that now all the obstacles and the negativities of not remembering the death and impermanent
and not generating a wish to attain liberation from the suffering of labrum, not generating a the fear, and also the not taking refuge in three jewels, and not generating a faith and devotion in the law of cause and effect. All obscurations are completely purified and become one's body now like clean, like a crystal, and then they visualize the rays of light and nectar descending down from the Lama Shakyatupa. Then to think that in the mind of yourself and all other sentient beings have received a very special strong realization about remembering death and impermanent, generating a wish to attain liberation from the suffering of labrums, strong faith in three jewels, and strong belief and in law of cause and effect. So then after that again we try to contemplate and meditate on this on the following topics: the certainty of death, and the time of death being uncertain, and at the moment of death the Dhamma is the best way to help yourself. So by contemplating on these three topics one after another, then again we do the visualization of the light and nectar flowing down from the Lama Shakyatupa.
So
to think when you meditate on the certainty of the death, to think that at the time of death there is no better method than the practice of Dhamma. At that particular moment, no one could help you, and even if you possess all the material conditions, that doesn't help, except the holy the teaching. And then to make request to the Lama or crown level that may I be able to do something beneficial for the future form of rebirth, and to practice Dhamma immediately without any delay. Please give me the blessing.
So
And then to visualize the light nectar descending from that Lama, and you receive a special realization in your mind and all the mind of sentient being. The remembering about the realization of remembering about the death, and then it purifies all the negativities which hinders to meditate on death and impermanent, and then all sentient beings' body become extremely clear, which means no more afflictions remain in the mind. So then, to think that death is for certain, and when after that one must take a form of rebirth, and there's only two possibilities to take a rebirth, that is either superior form or lower form of rebirth. But if ever I born in the lower form of rebirth, then to remember those suffering of hell, and remember suffering of pretas, hungry ghost, and remember the suffering of animal realms. And then to make a request to the Lama of the Crown by receiving lace and nectar from the body.
Oh, then when they die, then they do doing seven men do be. They do doing then that's what they do be. Seven men do be.
Then request to the Lama of the Crown level that please give me a blessing to be able to avoid level form of rebirth, and to be able to take essence out of this precious human rebirth, and to born in superior form of rebirth.
What then you will have a coleman to do the Jibi Jib, Raja Sujata, you listen to you. Tom and Sabi did it, Chetan, Chabat, do you today? All Raja Sukasa can take a gizet to the job. The devil is in a castle ring and do any. Doing any, tie it in the toe. Top at the Raju Chavala than the bed.
So while doing the visualization of light and nectar, at the same time we should think that it purifies all the negativities that we have accumulated from innumerable lifetime, all the negativities in general, and particularly it purifies those obstacles which interfere to gain the realization of avoiding all the suffering of for the lower form of rebirth. And increasing the lifespan, the merit and understanding of scriptures, and thereby body of all sentient beings and yourself become very clean, clear.
Well, yeah, that's the name of Jesus. When you do it,
and then try to think on the methods of avoiding the suffering of labor realms, then the matter is to take refuge, sincere refuge in three jewels. If I take refuge in three jewels, and then to respect the law of cause and effect, then I will be able to avoid all sufferings of Labaram. And having contemplated on that, then try to generate a very strong feeling towards our refuge, which means a very strong confidence. Just as, for example, someone who commits a criminal problem, and then that person, you know, gives lot of hope, puts a lot of hope in the one who, to one who help. In the same way, same kind of feeling should have to the rest of the three jewels.
Then the Nyasulam, the Toba Chevaja, and the Sinja Tanjur, Jesu, Samanam Chet.